Some people would like to see a kick-ass anime fight. Other people would like to watch a movie featuring Dolph Lundgren. This video is different. In this video, we are gonna talk statistics. Previously, we have stolen everything there is in Windhelm. We put it in Excel, we have made graphs, we had made tables, and now we're gonna share all this information with you. So let's get into the video. The sum value of every last item in Windhelm is a measly 67,552 septims. If you want the full data and graphs, you can find the link in the description below. Also, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you enjoy the content. In order to create a clear picture of the wealth of Windhelm, or rather lack of, we have decided to present it in comparison with that of Whiterun. As you can see in the graphs presented, the value of items in Windhelm is a whopping 10,000 septims less than that of Whiterun's. And now you ask me, but Snail, 78,000 is not so far off from 67,000. That is only 14% less than Whiterun. Why is Windhelm dirt poor? To answer that, let's put Windhelm City into context. As we know, every major city in Skyrim is plagued by a particular problem. In Markarth, we have the Forsworn. In Riften, we have corruption. And in Whiterun, well, we have Nazim. So what is plaguing Windhelm? Well, Windhelm problems are twofold. First, Windhelm is the headquarters of the Stormcloak Rebellion, and that takes its toll on the city, right? And secondly, we have racism. And as you all know, racism is not good for anything. I mean, think about it. Even the first sight that you have when you enter the city is of a bunch of Nords picking on a dark elf. So starting from this, let us discuss the repercussions of which Windhelm suffers because of its ideology. So racism brings after itself isolation and segregation. These two factors will always impede on trading. Windhelm even has a port that would mean that its economy should bloom. They could trade with Morrowind or even establish a trading hub for all Eastern Skyrim. But because of its ideology, that doesn't happen, and the city suffers for it. Establishing that, let's jump into the in-depth analysis. As I mentioned earlier, we're gonna use Whiterun as an etalon. While doing the heist in the city of Whiterun, we have counted 63 NPCs and 28 guards, for a total of 91 people living there. In Windhelm, on the other hand, we have counted 56 NPCs and 27 guards, with a total of 83 people living here. Let's keep that in mind and jump into the analysis. First off, let's compare the city strictly to a numerical standpoint. As we can see, the only categories in which Windhelm wins are potions and scrolls. But that is only because there are no scrolls to be found in Whiterun. Trying to be more intellectual honest, let's calculate the value per capita. That means dividing the value of each category to the number of citizens of each city. Doing this, we reveal that actually Windhelm wins in three categories. It wins in apparel, we will discuss that later. It wins in potions, that is obvious, and in scrolls. The biggest discrepancies we can spot is in books and miscellaneous. As we can see, Whiterun citizens read 60% more than those of Windhelm. Another thing we can see by the gold stolen from each city is that Windhelm citizens have 26% less than Whiterun. Having the bigger picture discussed, let's delve into each category one by one. Chapter 1. Weapons. There are 21 unique weapons in Windhelm, with a total of 184 weapons. Again, the most common weapon is the Iron Dagger, followed closely by the Imperial Bow. Talking about ways of inflicting damage, let's look at the two cities. As we can see, the most common weapon in both cities is the dagger. The difference arises when we talk about the percentage of swords, maces, and axes. These three categories of weapons are more commonly used in Windhelm. This is because in Windhelm, each guard fights with their weapon of choice. On the other hand, in Whiterun, each city guard is equipped with a sword. At first, I thought that Ulfric was onto something by letting the soldiers fight with what they prefer. But then, I thought about the Romans and how they achieved victory through uniformity in army. I'm no army specialist, so if there is one out there, please shed some light in the comments. My fear of an ill-prepared army was further deepened when I found out the material used in order to forge the weapons. We can see in the graphs that in Windhelm, Most of the weapons are iron. That is worse than in Whiterun, where most of the weapons are steel. So we can safely conclude in this category that the weaponry in Windhelm is worse than the weaponry in Whiterun. Chapter 2. Apparel. In this category, Windhelm gets the crown. However, this is only due to an in-game mechanic. The mechanic I'm speaking about is, of course, leveled loot. In Windhelm, we have a lot of knapsacks lying around. These knapsacks will always contain a piece of jewelry that is leveled to your character. In accord with this, we found a lot of jewelry that artificially raises the value of apparel in Windhelm. So let's do a breakdown. We have 99 unique apparel with a total number of 529 units. Talking about occurrence, jewelry is the least common apparel item. However, more than 70% of the apparel value is reprised by jewelry. Talking about clothing, we can see that because of the segregation and racism present here in Windhelm, class discrepancies are huge compared to those of Whiterun. Here, more than 73% of clothes are poor man's clothes. Only 27% are rich men's. The percentage in Whiterun was almost 50-50. Although the class discrepancies are huge, the value of rich men's garments is 3 times more than the value of poor men's. Talking about jewelry, the total value is almost 20,000 septim. We can see here that 37% of the jewels are amulets and 63 are rings. Also, an interesting fact is that 26% of jewels are enchanted. In regards to the city guard, it takes 87 septims to equip a Windhelm guard and 155 septims to equip a Whiterun one. Chapter 3. Potions. The number of unique potions in Windhelm is 42, with a total number of potions of 101. The funny thing to talk here is that the most expensive potion, being the solution of enhanced stamina, costs more than almost double all the poor man's clothes. Although I don't like Windhelm, this thing is the most interesting. So the only poison in the city is frostbite venom. That's the only thing. As you can see in the graph, only 5% of the potions found here in the city are poisons, compared to Whiterun, where 25% of those were poisoned. Chapter 4. Food. Off the bat, we can see that people in Windhelm spend 18.2% less on food than those of Whiterun. Talking about dietary habits, we can see that citizens of Windhelm prefer fruit and vegetables. Drinks only reprise the third place. So 57% of their produce consumption is from agricultural origins. This is pretty strange considering the location of Windhelm. Here in Windhelm, we found 99 bottles less than in Whiterun. The preferred drink in the city of Windhelm is the Nord Mead. This could be easily explained by the fact that this city is very nationalistic. Talking about meat consumption, we can see that only 10% of the meats are poultry, rest of them being mammal and fish. Like in Whiterun, citizens from this city also prefer green apples. For all you Sheogorat fans out there, this is the cheese distribution in Windhelm. God damn, we have a lot of cheese! The preferred vegetable of the city is the potato. No surprise there. The surprise comes from the fact that the second is cabbage, followed by carrot, and the tomato only takes fourth place. Talking about quality of life, just check out the numbers of the desserts in Whiterun versus the desserts in Windhelm. People here don't have a sweet tooth. Or Ulfric is forbidden it. I don't know. Only thing we can draw from here is that the quality of life in Windhelm is a few steps back from the quality of life in Whiterun. And for the first time in the series, the most common dessert is drumroll, sweet roll. Chapter 5. Ingredients. You can see here the ingredients distribution throughout Windhelm. A noteworthy thing to be mentioned here is that you can find 4 giant toes. So for those of you that want a good start at the game, just come here and steal those toes. You have 2 in Calixto's museum and 2 in the Jarl's mage's quarter. Another information we got from this heist is that citizens of Windhelm do not like flowers. Just look at the numbers. We have 600 flowers in Whiterun and only 175 in Windhelm. Chapter 6. Books. We have 85 unique books in Windhelm with a total number of 151. The most expensive book you can find in the city is the Knights of the Nine with a value of 70 septim. Talking about the preferred book series, we can see, and no surprise here, that the most popular book series in Windhelm is the Song of Pelinal. For those of you who do not know, the Song of Pelinal is about the biggest murderer of elves from history. Talking about numbers and doing a comparison between Whiterun and Windhelm, we can see that Whiterun has 3 times more books than the city of Windhelm. Chapter 7. Scrolls. Only one thing to be said here. We found 4 scrolls in the city of Windhelm with a total value of 2000 septims. That means 3% of all of wealth in Windhelm is reprised by the scrolls. Chapter 8. Miscellaneous. During the heist, we found out that there are 84 unique miscellaneous items in the city of Windhelm, with a total number of 1044. The most expensive items we found are the ruby and the Berenzaya crown gem, with a value of 200 septims. Looking at these tables, one from Windhelm, one from Whiterun, we can draw quality of life comparisons. As you can see, in Whiterun, they prefer ceramics. This is given by the number of bowls, goblets, jugs, and plates. Whereas, in Windhelm, they prefer wood. Chapter 9. Conclusions. This graph shows the percentage of each kind of item in Windhelm. As you can see, apparel only takes 13%. However, if we look at it money-wise, apparel takes 40% of all the value of Windhelm. And to say it again, the total value of all the items in Windhelm is 67,552 septims. In conclusion, because of the racism that plagues this city, its inhabitants suffer. The army of Windhelm is worse equipped than the army of Whiterun, and the quality of life of its citizens is net inferior. Hope you have enjoyed the content. And if you did, please comment, like, and subscribe. See you in the next time, guys, when we'll talk about Riften.